जय हिंद एवरी वन। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड। फ्रेंड्स, दिस वीडियो इज़ गोइंग टू बी वेरी हेल्पफुल फ्रॉम SSB ग्रुप डिस्कशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू और एज वेल एज लेक्चरेट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस सर्टन एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड, वाई यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड इज़ नीडेड, वॉट आर द चैलेंजेस टू यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड, वॉट आर द मेरिट्स ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म सिविल कोड्स और what could be a way forward to implement the uniform civil code in our country. Friends, first of all, if I will tell you, Goa is the only state in our country where a common civil code is implemented and applicable, and that Goan civil code is known as Portuguese Civil Code 1867. It means that Goan domicile, they have a common civil code where every citizen, whether he or she is from different religions, they have to follow a common set of rules and regulations, and that common civil code will govern every citizen of the Goa domicile. Friends, but a uniform civil code is not in use recently. It was first time was in news in 1985 when Supreme Court for the first time directed Parliament to frame a uniform civil code in 1985. In case of Muhammad Ahmad Khan versus Shah Bano Begum, that case is popularly known as Shah Bano case. Friends, in this case, Shah Bano claimed for maintenance from her husband after she was given the triple talaq by him or talaq-e-biddat. Friends, we all know that in 2018 and 2017, triple talaq was in news. So what is that triple talaq? Triple talaq means that if the husband will announce talaq, talaq and talaq for three times, it means there will be a legal talaq in the Muslim personal laws. But uniform civil code, now let me tell you what is uniform civil code. Friends, uniform civil code seeks to replace all the personal laws based on the customs of each major religious communities in India with a common set of rules and regulations governing every citizen. Friends, first of all, let me tell you that what is the status of personal laws in India. If we talk about Indian cultural diversity, Indian religious diversity, there are different religions in our country and each religions have their different personal laws. And friends, the personal law subjects like marriage, divorce, inheritance come under the concurrent list. According to the Hindu personal law that also apply to Sikh, Jain and Buddhist, the Hindu personal law was basically codified in 1956, and friends, Hindu personal law have been by and large very secular and modernized by the statutory enactments. There has been change in the personal laws after independence, and in 1956, the Hindu personal laws was codified based on the equality and proper justice in the system. Friends, but Muslim personal laws, all the Muslims in India are codified under Sharia law of 1937 that governs all Muslims in India. And apart from it, Jews and Christians are also governed by their respective personal laws. So what is the need for a uniform civil code? Friends, if we talk about the needs of uniform civil code, you will get to know that different personal laws in a country promote communalism. Because if we talk about the religious entities, there are different religious entities, and if there would be different personal laws for each religion, there could be a chances of communalism in the country, and it will also lead to discrimination at two levels. Friends, first of all, there would be a discrimination on the basis of religion, and the second, there would be a discrimination on the basis of sex, whether she is male or female, because we know that we are living in a male dominating society and a patriarchal mindset society. So in this, these two type of discriminations are very prominent, first on the basis of religion and the second on the basis of sex. Friends, uniform civil code will provide women with right to equality, justice in the court of law, irrespective of their religions, in matter pertaining to marriage, divorce, maintenance, custody of children, inheritance right, adoption, etc. So if there would be uniform civil code, women will get more rights, they will feel more equal, and as well as there would be justice in the court of law, and they will also get benefits pertaining to marriage, divorce, maintenance, custody of women, inheritance, right, adoptions, and etc. Friends, but what are the challenges regarding to Uniform Civil Code? As the coin has two faces, there are challenges too. First challenge is constitutional challenges. Friends, in our constitution, Article 25 deals with freedom of religion, as well as Article 26 and 29 also deals with the freedom of religion as well as the cultural distinction. But Article 14 and 15 deals with right to equality. So there will be a challenge between right to freedom as well as right to equality. So this could be the constitutional changes. There are other socio-political challenges, like minority will fear that culture of the majority is being imposed over them. Cultural diversity in India is a big challenge because there are various religions in our country, and if all religions will be come under one, there could be a challenge regarding this. And the other thing is patriarchal mindset of the Indian society. As we all know that according to the Hindu personal law 1956, the inheritance law is there for the women too. But as we all know the status that the women holds very less amount of lands as well as the inherit property from their parents is very low in our country. So friends, what could be the merits in Uniform Civil Code? First of all, if Uniform Civil Code in our country is implemented, there would be a chances of national integration, because there will be feeling of equal society, there will be a feeling of secular society, and there will be a feeling that the entire country is governed by one rules and regulations, so all people are equal before the law. There would be simplification in the laws, because today different personal laws have different rules and regulations, so every citizen is governed by different personal laws. So dear friends, if there would be a Uniform Civil Code, there would be the simplification in laws for every citizen, there would be one set of rules and regulations, and this will make things very simple. There would be an establishment of a secular society in our country, and there would be promotion of the gender justice. As I have said that gender inequality is there in our country, because we live in a male dominating society. The people over here has a patriarchal mindset, and there is definitely the gender injustice in our country. As we have seen that recently when triple talaq was abolished, so triple talaq was a form of gender injustice in our country against the Muslim women. And regarding many things, like in Hindus, the polygamy is not applicable, but in Muslims it was applicable. So if all Indians will be governed by the same rules, there would be more gender justice. Now friends, Uniform Civil Code, its implementation is not so easy. So what could be the way forward? Friends, the social transformation from diverse civil code to uniformity shall be gradual. It should be very gradual, because it cannot happen in a day. The government must adopt a piecemeal approach, means doing everything step by step. Government should bring separate aspects such as marriage, adoption, succession and maintenance into Uniform Civil Code into stages. Means we have to do in a systematic way, stage by stage. First of all, solve the problem of marriage related issues, then adoption, then succession, then maintenance, then inheritance. We have to do it in successive stages. No, or there could be a chances that there should be not a common law, but every personal law is based on the principle of equality, liberty and justice. It could be another a possibility. The government should increase awareness about the Uniform Civil Code a lot. Uniform Civil Code, the merits of Uniform Civil Code should be aware to each and every citizen of the country, so that they could happily adopt it. They are ready to use the Uniform Civil Code. They are if Uniform Civil Code in our country will be implemented, they are not going to protest. So Uniform Civil Code must be a balance between protection of fundamental rights and religious dogmas of individual. So friends, I hope that Uniform Civil Code is I have made justice with this topic, and you have understood this topic well. So friends, if you love this video, then please follow me on SSB Goals, my Instagram account, as well as please like and subscribe this channel and share this channel to maximum you can. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you for watching this video till last.